Hi, thanks for stopping by. If it's your first time here, my name is Lisa, and I'd love it if you subscribed and liked and commented. And for those of you who are returning, I appreciate you coming back, spending or wasting your time with me, and seeing what I got. So, just to cut straight to the chase, poor Renji is outside walking with my husband, so there's no Renji cameo. Maybe I'll slide in a picture or something of him here, but today's video is about my Paris trip. My girlfriend Amy, who you've seen in a previous video, and I went to Paris, kind of on a whim, but we asked around and nobody could either go because of prior obligations, family commitments, work, blah, blah, blah. So she and I took a trip to Paris and we completely had a blast. I want to show you some of the things I got, starting with the smallest to the, oh my God. So I hope you stick around and watch. The smallest item is, it's a windmill, and it's actually a souvenir from Moulin Rouge. You put the oil in it, and then you put the paper windmill in it, and it becomes a diffuser. So that is my smallest and first souvenir. So this is the scent that comes with it. It is called La Vie en Rouge, and it actually smells really good. I didn't take the plastic cap off because I'm scared to spill it, but this is gonna go awesome in, I think, a small space or maybe even at work, but it smells really good. I will say this, I think that the Moulin Rouge show was unexpected, but interesting and surprising. But I am grateful that I went, and I am grateful that I got a super cool souvenir, so there's that. Now, my next souvenir is a mini Eiffel Tower, and my friend Amy and I went out and caught the show. So, fun fact, one, the Eiffel Tower was originally only meant to stand for 6 months, and it was actually painted red originally. And then secondly, every night, I believe it's 10 and 11, for 5 minutes, they do like a light show. Of course at night, it's lit up no matter what, but they do like a little cool light show at night, every night for, when I say 5 minutes, I mean exactly 5 minutes. So if you miss 10, we'll see you at 11. So that is my second one, and I think she's adorable. Now my third one is this super cool snow globe, but you cannot turn the music off and still see it blow around the Eiffel Tower, so, and make it change color. So we're just gonna turn that off and then let it settle for a second. And then you can see the Eiffel Tower inside, and she is beautiful. So, and heavy, she's a solid girl. So that is my third, I would say, inexpensive souvenir. Now, we did do a little touring, and, well, actually, we did a lot of touring. We did a lot of walking, at least a gazillion miles a day. It was a lot of walking, but it was worth it, and it was fun, and it was entertaining. So, I also picked up, even though I really am not a silver girl, but I thought it was so cute, I couldn't pass on it. It's from Pandora, and there is a Can-Can girl from Paris, a Winnie the Pooh, because it means something special to me personally, and the Eiffel Tower to also, with the Can-Can girl, commemorate that memory. And I hope that when I'm old and senile, I never forget this trip, because it was amazing. And yeah, it was amazing. So there's that. Just so you know, none of my luxury goods are boxed up because of suitcase space, customs, logistics, blah. None of them are boxed. So I'm just going to show you. And Gucci sneakers. Anybody spot the difference? They're two different sizes, because one is for my husband and the other one is for me. So I got us matchy matchy sneakers. I thought they were adorable, and we love the matchy matchy game. So those are the sneakers. Next from Gucci is a men's toiletry case because my husband needed a new one. It is adorable. I love it. I think that, yeah, this is probably, I think, one of the best ones he's had so far. And the service in Gucci was just awesome. I mean, it was just awesome. My awesome is a here, Lee. Hi, Lee. Was able to score us an appointment, and sure enough, that guy was amazing. He was just nice and patient and kind and just everything with us. Both of us had a good time, and yeah, he was just awesome. So Leonardo, if you go to Paris and go to Gucci, see Leonardo at Champs-Élysées. That whole strip is just amazing. And now for the big, not the big guns, but you know, my girls. So this, I don't even remember what this bag was called, but when I saw it, I was like, that's so not me that I love it. So there she is. So she, on a slim frame, she could be crossbody, but not on me. So she is a shoulder bag, a crossbody, and a handheld bag. Magnets. I love magnets. Thank you, thank you. Pocket up front, pocket up back, and a zippered pocket in the way back. I really like that the zippered pocket. I think that she is gonna fit right on in with my regular girls. And I was a little funny about the silver and the gold mixed metals, but no, I'm already over it. I like it. So there we are. Yeah, she's beautiful. We also scooted on over to Dior, which was not in the plan. And there was something I had wanted from our Dior store here locally in Honolulu, and they just stopped selling it. And it was from their home store. So I was able to pick up the notebook. Yes, she's beautiful. Yes, I love it. And I thought she was just a beautiful score. So I wanted another notebook. Did I need one? Probably not, but I wanted another notebook, and I think she's beautiful. So if your local Dior is still selling them, I recommend you get one, because if not, they're kind of hard to get. So there's my Dior notebook. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the Deauville. Amy and I stopped in Chanel. Well, actually, we went twice to the original store with the apartment up top. And the first day, we got there at 7:04, and they closed at 7 o'clock. And I mean 7 o'clock sharp. So there was that. And then the next day, we went back early, and there was no line. I was so happy that there was not a line. So I got a Deauville. Isn't she beautiful? I had been wanting one for a while, but I just felt like the price was just too much for a cloth bag. And originally I wanted the leather version, but it was god awful heavy. When I picked it up, I was like, no way. And then this is actually not the largest one. There's one larger, but when I picked it up, it was also one, a little bit heavy, and two, I just felt like I'm gonna load that up. I'm gonna have a blow dryer, a can opener, and a Rubik's Cube in my bag every single day, because this thing is, I'm gonna make it heavy. So that's that. That's why I went with the smaller version. And I did not know it came with this cute pouch either until, you know, until I opened it up. And the service there was amazing. It was exactly what I expected out of Chanel in Paris, hands down. I mean, although I love my SA here and I have a really good rapport with him, this was unmatched. One more. I would say Gucci and Chanel were neck and neck on service, which was excellent. So there's that. And also, while I was there, I misspoke. I did have one thing to unbox, so just hang on one second. There we are. So the Deauville actually came in a box just like this, but of course supersized. And I wanted to keep it so bad because I had never seen the box like that. It was like a little, like a present, basically, and I love that. So, oh yeah. I felt kind of bad for the housekeeper because she had a lot of stuff to throw away. Yeah, I felt almost bad for her. So, there's that. And I just got a card holder. It wasn't the exact one I wanted. I wanted the one my friend Angie has. It has a zip around, but I could never find it. And this one seems to be never in my local store when I'm looking for it. So I just went ahead and picked it up. And she's beautiful and she's cute. And she goes perfect with all my other Chanel. Well, I wouldn't say all my other Chanel stuff. I would say my other two bags that I already own. So this Deauville makes number three. And I can say that I think that that's probably my last Chanel. Yeah, I think so. Because even with the VAT and all of that good stuff, it's still expensive. So I think that, maybe. I'm saying that now, but I probably don't mean it. So yeah, we'll see. Most forgot to throw in my Gucci shoes. I know that they are not for everybody, but I think they will be for me. And I like how there's a snake at the bottom. Isn't that cool? I like them. So, they're cute, I think. Yeah. And they're actually quite comfortable. I thought they would be uncomfortable, but the platform is just high enough as to where it's not like an ankle breaker for me, you know, because I look like a deer with Down syndrome walking it in heels. I really do. It's a terrible sight, and I hope nobody ever sees it again. So, these are my new Gucci shoes. And now for the showstopper from Louis Vuitton. Boom! Oh my gosh. Let's give her a whirl. Isn't she gorgeous? The camera box. Now, I was tossed up between this and the Speedy that was also a trunk. I'll insert a picture of it here. And I went with this one because as soon as I picked up the Speedy, I was like, absolutely not. That bag is so heavy, it would just sit there and collect dust. And I don't buy my bags to do that. I buy them to wear and collect dust while I take it, wherever I'm going. I don't want something just to sit there. That's not for me. So, yes. And the service at Louis Vuitton in Paris. My essay here got me an appointment in Paris, and oh my gosh, they had us in a little private room. You know, it was all hoity-toity, champagne, macaroons, you know, these weird juices that I kept seeing. They leave, it's a thick juice. I don't know how to describe it, but I saw it everywhere. It's a thick Parisian, like a fruit juice, but it was super thick. And yeah, so all of that, and they were super nice to us. And he stamped my tag with an R for Ringy and the Eiffel Tower of trunks. And I also took my passport holder and had her stamp that as well, but it's somewhere downstairs, so we won't be doing that. But yeah, she's gorgeous and beautiful and not, she is solid. Don't get me wrong. She's a heavy girl, but she is not anything compared to that Speedy. She was just so heavy that you could just you could, I could just imagine me never using it because it's so heavy and so ridiculous. It's ridiculously, beautifully heavy, and there's no way I could do that. There's no way. So this, I could easily see me rocking, because actually I'm probably going to wear it to work tomorrow. So there's that. Now, for Paris in general, I am probably going to do a separate video with recommendations and, you know, the things we saw and all the art and all of those things. I'll probably get to that probably in another week. But it was such an amazing time, and I firmly suggest that you do a guided tour and that you take a purse that zips closed, because if the people at the airport, the cab driver, the waiters at the restaurants, the tour guides, and the people at the hotel tell you to be careful of pickpockets, they actually mean it. So luckily, I brought plenty of bags. I took my Neverfull just to travel with, and as soon as I got to the hotel, I dumped it and used a zippered bag the whole time. And at first, I was kind of uncomfortable with taking, you know, a luxury bag with me, but here's the thing. I wanted to go to Paris and be a tourist. I'm not trying to see where you live. I'm not trying to go where you grocery shop. I don't want to see that. I want to see the Eiffel Tower and touristy things. So I felt like if I just stayed in my little tourist lane, I'd be safe. And I was correct. So if you're the type to get on a train and go discover, you know, where people live and how people live, then yeah, you might want to take a, what's that bag? A Lululemon bag. But if you're just going to be like me doing guided tours and eating, you know, within the Eiffel Tower area or the city where, you know, all the tourists are, you'll be fine. You will be fine, because we saw Birkins and Kellys and, you know, Chanel's up the wazoo, and nobody was bothering anybody. The city was clean and it was safe. So I hope you enjoyed my unboxing. Sorry I haven't been around. And I hope that you come back soon. And I hope you have a great day. Thank you for your time. Thanks for watching. For those of you who got this far, I appreciate you. And for those of you who don't, I get it. You know, I'm the queen of fast forwarding. If you're saying something crazy, I fast forward to the good stuff. So that's it. Thank you. Aloha, and have a great day. Oh, 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 oh